Hey guys, my name is Sid. Welcome to another tech review. Today we're going to be checking out the DJI Mavic Mini 2. Now they've improved the Mavic Mini in a lot of ways with this drone. It might look the same, but it's drastically different from the previous drone in a couple of key ways. But before we talk more about this drone, let's check out some of the video that you get out of this now in 4K, 30 frames a second. So as you guys can see, the image quality coming out of this is pretty remarkable for the size of the drone. I mean, this is an incredibly small drone. If you guys want to know more about the dimensions of this and how it works, I did do a review of the Mavic Mini. It's still pretty much the same design wise. One differentiating factor is that it does have these orange tips on the propellers, and the battery of this one is a little bit different compared to the previous one. So if you have a Mavic Mini, you can't use the same batteries with this drone. So just keep that in mind. Other than that, it has a 4K camera now, as opposed to the 2.7K camera on the previous Mavic Mini. The motors on this are also improved from the previous Mavic Mini, which means that not only does the drone operate faster, so you can get to places quicker with this drone as opposed to the previous one, but it also fights the wind better. So it's much more stable in high winds. Sports mode on this is far better than what it is on the Mavic Mini. And you definitely do feel the difference in power from this compared to the previous Mavic Mini. Now, it's not as quick as the Mavic Air 2. As you might imagine, this is almost half the price of the Mavic Air 2. But overall, a huge improvement over the Mavic Mini. Now, I think the biggest improvement to this drone is the inclusion of OcuSync 2.0. So OcuSync is DJI's proprietary transmission technology, which allows it now to have a 10 kilometer range compared to about a kilometer on the previous Mavic Mini. So that is a huge difference. So it helps you in a couple of key ways. And if you're not using the 10 kilometer range of this drone, you're gonna get a much better and more stable image while you're flying the drone. Now, I can't explain to you how terrifying it is when you lose transmission with your drone, which does happen with the Mavic Mini. I'm just used to it now. I usually fly a Spark and the transmission quality on that is pretty poor. So the previous Mavic Mini just used to use an extension of Wi-Fi, but OcuSync is just a completely different wireless transmission technology, which allows you to have that amazing range. It gives you 1080p video right on your phone. So it's much easier to control the drone, not only at long distances, but even when it's close by. I think I just saw one or two stutters in the whole time I was flying, which is pretty amazing for this drone. So it's the same transmission technology that's on the Mavic Air 2. In fact, the Mavic Air 2 is rated for, I think, 7.5 kilometers, and this one is rated for 10 kilometers. Now, in order to facilitate OcuSync 2.0, they have given you this new controller over here, which I did speak about. It's pretty much the same controller from the Mavic Air 2. There are a couple of compromises you're making with the controller. It is a bit more bulky compared to the previous one, but if I had the choice between a slimmer controller and OcuSync 2.0, I would definitely take OcuSync 2.0 because this makes the whole flying experience a lot smoother. I went over this in my Mavic Air 2 review as well, but the design of this controller is really nice. The phone fits on the top over here. You've got a place to store your joysticks at the bottom of the controller. You've got sports mode, cine mode, and then normal mode in the middle. You've got a dedicated button for return to home, which is really nice. So overall, great controller, great ergonomics. I just wish it was a little bit smaller. I'm sure DJI is gonna reduce the size of this controller in the next generation, but considering the amazing transmission quality and distance you're getting out of this controller, definitely worth the upgrade from the Mavic Mini. Now, let's talk about the image quality coming out from the Mavic Mini 2 now. Notice a huge difference in, say, dynamic range or the way the video looks, apart from the resolution. So at 4K resolution, everything just looks a little bit more crisp. If you want to reframe a shot or something like that, you're going to have a lot more flexibility with the 4K camera. That's a big improvement as well when it comes to the Mavic Mini 2. Now, the Mavic Mini still does have a few downsides. This does not have any forward-facing sensors, so you might hit something on the front. It doesn't have rear-facing sensors either. No sensors at the top, only at the bottom. So you just have to be a little bit careful while flying this drone to make sure you don't hit something. There's also a slight visual difference. There's a LED now in the front of it, and at the back of the drone, you have your SD card reader as well as your USB-C, which makes it much easier to recharge this drone as well. It's still got the same 249 gram weight, so it will be easy to travel with. A lot of countries don't have any restrictions on you flying drones under 250 grams. They don't need to be registered. So that's a huge advantage for this drone as well. I know nobody's traveling right now, but eventually when we do start, it's going to be really good for that. Now, DJI is still selling both these drones. So they're selling the Mavic Mini at about $400 and they're selling the Mavic Mini 2 at $450. And to me, it is a no-brainer. If you're trying to decide between these two drones, definitely 100% spend the extra $50 and get the Mavic Mini 2. Just for the transmission quality, the controller, you're definitely gonna feel a lot more confident flying this drone over the Mavic Mini. You're also getting that 4K quality. This is almost as good as a Mavic Air 2 now. It's an easy recommendation. If you're a beginner, if you're looking to get your first drone, DJI has by far made the best beginner drone ever with the DJI Mavic Mini 2. If you already have a Mavic Mini and you're thinking of upgrading to this, I still think it's probably worth it if you can sell off your Mavic Mini and get a good price for it, because the transmission quality on this is absolutely amazing. It just makes you feel a lot more secure when you're flying around your, you know, $450 drone. All right, guys, if you're looking to buy a Mavic Mini 2, go check out lgadgets.com. I'll leave a link in the description. They have the Mavic Mini 2 as well as the Fly More combo. I would recommend going for the Fly More combo since you get the extra batteries in it and all the accessories that you need. I think the Fly More combo in Dubai is going for around 2,200 dirhams. Really good price for a beginner drone. And this is definitely highly recommended for anybody looking to start this hobby. I'll leave a link in the description for lgadgets.com. Big thanks to them for letting me borrow the drone and check it out. If I were buying a drone today, I would be buying this one. So if you like this video, hit that like button, leave me a comment, subscribe to watch more videos like this, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.